Trinidad and Tobago. How you feeling? Ministers of government, members of the diplomatic corps, members of the media, fellow citizens of Trinidad and Tobago, I have on my left our first gold medalist winner, Hazy Crawford. Make some noise! And on my right, is our second gold medalist in this our golden jubilee year of independence, Keshorn Walcott. Make some noise! And also with us here, in addition to this young man from Toko, we have a young man from Superior, Jazane Phillips. As the whole world now knows, Keshorn was born and raised in the village of Toko. Make some noise for Toko! I am told that young Keshorn would throw bamboo stalks on the beach of that village. Little did he know, we know, that he would one day bring gold back to Trinidad and Tobago. You know, usually when anyone says they're taking a drive to Toko, it would mean that they go to enjoy the beauty of the beaches, the people, the sights and experiences of that place. Toko now takes on a whole new meaning. It has become synonymous with the great achievement of our sun, of our soil, by producing our second gold medalist. And so, again, I ask you to acknowledge the first man who brought us gold once again, Hazy Crawford. And I said to Hazy that young Keshorn would need a mentor. And who would be a better mentor than Hazy Crawford, having gone through this experience himself? And so when Keshorn won the World Junior Championship in Barcelona just a month ago, it was a sign of things to come. And when he got the gold medal, he became the youngest winner in Olympic history of the javelin event, and the first man in our Western Hemisphere to win in 60 years. And Keshorn has another first. He has become the first Trinbagonian to win a medal for Trinidad and Tobago in a field event. To secure this achievement, he had to produce his own best and a national record to be the final 8 best javelin throwers in the world. All this from this young 19-year-old man from Tobago, Toko, from Toko. I'm thinking of Dwight York from Tobago too. Toko. And so Keshorn would shine as a beacon of light to the young people of our nation. All those who have dreams of achieving great things in their lifetimes, Keshorn would stand as a beacon of light. And so today, in addition to other honors we will bestow on Keshorn, I want to say that Toko Lighthouse will be named the Keshorn Walcott Toko Lighthouse. Today is a day in the history of our nation when every citizen stands hand in hand, beaming with patriotic pride and passion as one people. It has been some time since we felt the surge of nationalism as we do today. we welcome the young men and women, the children of independence, who brought glory to Trinidad and Tobago in this our golden jubilee year of independence. It has been more than 3.5 decades since the Trinidad and Tobago athlete won gold. And to Keshorn Walcott, I say, thank you, Keshorn. Thank you, Keshorn. Thank you, Keshorn. The inspiration you have become is really the stuff that dreams are made of. The pride we feel today, we cannot adequately express. Your medal represents what is possible from us. As a tiny speck on the globe map, as a small nation, but with great potential. It is a timely reminder of what we can achieve against all odds. Your gold medal achievement is an inspiration to every single citizen, to every young man and woman, to every young boy and girl in our land. It is a lesson in self-belief, is an expression of what being a citizen of our great nation truly means. And so today, as we mark the golden achievement of Keshorn, I want to acknowledge the collective representation of all athletes who took part in our Olympics. They brought home 4 medals, and others qualified for the record 12 of our athletes in the finals in the world. We are proud of them. As I say to you, some of the honors we'll bestow on our athletes, I want to let you know that a separate ceremony has been planned to announce the ways in which our athletes will be honored and celebrated. Details on this will be forthcoming as we acknowledge them all as heroes. Today, I want to pay tribute to the efforts of our Honorable Minister of Sport, Anil Roberts. Your efforts have paid off. Anil promised us, when we fielded the largest contingent ever to enter the Olympic Games, he promised us that they would produce the best returns in our nation's history. Anil, you promised and you delivered. Done. Thank you very much. As a minister, you know that all you get is the satisfaction of having done your nation proud, and the acknowledgement of everyone in TNT for a job well done. That is your badge of honor. Wear it well, Minister Roberts, and let it inspire you to do even more. We cannot forget the coaches and the trainers behind our athletes, as well without whom we could not get the results that we achieved. Give us some noise, make some noise for our coaches and trainers. While time will not permit me to mention everyone, I want to acknowledge the efforts of Keshorn's gold medal producing coach, Ishmael Lopez. He's here with us today. Coach Lopez, thank you. Thank you very much. You have done an amazing job. We honor you, and we will promise you here today that your appeal for facilities for field events will be realized. I have asked the Minister of Sport to bring a recommendation before the Cabinet for consideration to establish facilities for field events in Trinidad and Tobago. I also wish to announce that due consideration will be made for appropriate recognition for Coach Lopez's accomplishments in guiding young Keshorn to these heights of achievement and to national glory. As you know, last evening, I advise His Excellency the Acting President that today be appointed a national holiday in honor of our Olympic achievements and in recognition of the glory that our athletes have brought to our country. Today, I wish to announce the following to all of you, in the presence of our returning heroes, that Keshorn Walcott, born in Toko, Trinidad and Tobago, will be honored by the government and people of our nation, including in the following ways. For bringing us such pride and recognition to the nation of Trinidad and Tobago, K Keshorn Walcott will receive, as I already said, the naming of the Toko Lighthouse as a Keshorn Walcott Toko Lighthouse. And of course, Keshorn returned today on Caribbean Airlines. And so, we will name one of our new aircraft in honor of Keshorn Walcott. In addition, 20,000 square feet of land in Keshorn's, in the vicinity of Keshorn's hometown in Toko. And in addition to that 20,000 square feet of land we will give to him, we will have a housing development project in Toko. This housing development to be done by the Ministry of Housing and the HDC will bring housing and employment jobs to Toko. Thank you, Keshorn. Our 19-year-old golden Olympic hero, Keshorn Walcott, will receive the sum of $1 million. $1 million to be but that's not all. That $1 million to be invested as he desires. Keshorn Walcott, youngest ever gold medal winner of the javelin throw in Olympic history, will receive a home in Federation Park. That home in Federation Park is valued in the sum of $2.5 million. There is more to come. We'll announce those at a later date. But should Keshorn so desire, as a young student, he will be awarded, should he accept, a scholarship to the University of Trinidad and Tobago to further his studies in his chosen field, while his coach Lopez will be placed in charge of an elite throws program at the University of Trinidad and Tobago, where all future talent, including that of Keshorn himself, can develop in field events. Keshorn, of all ways, each of these rewards honor you. There is nothing greater than the glory you have brought to Trinidad and Tobago, and no greater expression than the pride and gratitude that we all feel. And so as I close, I say, on behalf of the entire nation of Trinidad and Tobago, thank you, Keshorn. Thank you, Keshorn. Thank you, Keshorn.